Within the last 4 months, this agroforestry system has been growing faster than anything around it. I mean, just look at these crazy big banana palms. I can literally not get them into frame. So, why? Well, it has something to do with this box. But before we look inside of it, where even are we?
This is Camping Guáimaro, named after the big guáimaro tree standing right over there next to the cliff. It is a beautiful campsite right next to Barichara, run by the lovely couple of Julia and Joep, who will be helping us today. Now this far out, there's of course no access to public sewage. Nonetheless, they decided to build flush toilets, entirely flushed with rain and recycled wastewater. And to process the black and gray waters, instead of a septic tank, they built an incredible biofilter with layers of plants, sand and gravel. It cleans so well, in fact, that when Joep's father came to visit,
we took a test out of the test pit with this water after filtration, and we put another glass of water next to it so my father could have a look. But he started drinking it straight away, which was not the idea. But he said it was pretty good, and he said he felt pretty good as well, so.
It is really, really clean. But about 1.5 years ago, Joep and Julia decided the capacity wasn't going to be enough if they wanted to have more guests at the campsite. So they built this box, which is a vermicomposting system.
It's basically a system to clean black water, wastewater from the toilets, and with worms. So the worms basically decompose everything which is in that wastewater. We have the pipe running from the two bathrooms all the way down to the vermicomposting system. The pipe is still partly visible. It goes in the top of the house, just underneath the roof, and from there it connects to the IBC tanks. But one tank at a time, so we have chosen to have like a flexible 4-inch tube at the end inside the house, so we can move actually between the two tanks. So we've always access in case of cleaning or whatever for one of the two.
Before we have a closer look at the leech field and the crazy results the fertilizer this system produces can achieve, are you ready to have a look inside?
So you have the worms inside there, but they're of course not just worms stacked on worms, right? What else is in there in those tanks?
Basically mostly organic material, which is high in carbon. We went to the carpenters outside of Barichara to get a lot of wood shavings. And we also were chopping up just loads of dry stuff we could find here around the property. Twigs maybe maximum 1 centimeter thick, and leaves and grass, as long as it's dry. That's the most important thing.
All right, no more poop from now on. Let's switch to a graphic. So we have the water poop mixture being added on top, which forms a layer in which the worms live and eat. The particles are in theory big enough that they can't immediately pass through the big layer of organic material right below. But obviously the water can pass through, washing the finer worm castings with it, so that the worms are never drowning in liquids either. And that fertilizer water can then pass out at the bottom to be channeled into a leach field.
How much maintenance work is maintaining a vermicomposting system with living organisms inside of it?
Well, in the first few weeks, Julia was always checking daily to see how things were going and topping up sometimes with some materials and checking and stirring into the top layer to see if the worms were happy and stuff like that. And then the heat was too much. One of the most important things is to have a space for the worms where they are in darkness and where they live between 20 and 25 degrees Celsius. The challenge was mostly to get the temperature down because it can be pretty hot out here during the day. So that's why we started to create some more insulation. Apart from that first few weeks, now we do only once a week, we just move the hose inside the house from one tank to another. So it can be sort of more spread out over both tanks. That's what we do, and I think about every 9 months or something like that, we will have to top up on this carbon-rich...
Every 9 months?
Organic layer. Yeah, it's pretty easy.
Incredibly easy maintenance and basically no smell unless you're directly downwind. And all of that isn't even the best part yet. Are you ready for some worm poop water magic?
These worm droppings or worm castings are being flushed with the water all the way down and go through this pipe further down into a leach field. This leach field is basically like a big trench filled with the same type of carbon-rich organic material. And there it will basically feed the plants which are planted in that area. The feeding of those plants is like the main purpose, basically. and it is growing like crazy. The difference is like day and night, I would say. The upper layers where we have just the conventional centropic agroforestry systems, these lines, it's doing really well. It looks really nice. We've been mulching and everything, so it looks nice. But if you look at the infiltration area, it's three times as big and lush.
And what kind of things have you planted?
If we're in the productive species, should be predominantly trees, fruit trees. So we've planted, for example, cacao, breadfruit, papaya, bananas, plantains, some chickpeas, tree spinach. But apart from that, there are also some other species in there which may be considered as support species, maybe, to give shade. But I don't think they seem to be too essential there in that system, because everything is just exploding. So we could make like a closed loop. We could just eat the food, or we can maybe give it to the guests and they will go to the toilet. So we have like a closed circle. The lady who prototyped this, Wendy Howard, she says, like, we're not probably going to convince many people to use the typical dry composting toilets, which may be even better because they don't use any water. But you can just have the comfort of conventional toilets, and people will be more likely maybe to adopt these type of systems.
So here we have a system built almost entirely of recycled materials that doesn't smell and can treat the poop of up to 14 people. And all that just built with persistence, good planning, and volunteer labor. Closing our nutrient cycles is one of the most important things that we have to do in order to make local food production possible. And this is one of the coolest solutions I've seen. Well done, Joep and Julia, and all the volunteers that worked their ass off in the hot Colombian sun. Let's regenerate the earth.